So we've decided to put a surgical team and crew into a submarine, reduce it way down in size, and inject it into an artery.
You mean I'm going along?
As part of the crew, yes.
Wait a minute. They can't shrink me.
Our miniaturizer can shrink anything.
But I don't want to be miniaturized.
All right, so this is Ken Spriggs here doing part 10 of my Proteus build. I'm going to show you today the completed bottom hull of the sub. A lot of work went into that, a lot of scratch building, a lot of starts and stops, trial and error, mistakes, redos. So it was quite a job. It took me quite a while to get that all completed in the way I wanted it to be. So it turned out really good. I like my final product of it. So let me go ahead and show you what I ended up with and how that turned out. And here are the finished battery compartments. Here's the other side. I still have to do some sanding and paint that there as well. Here's the first one that I completed. I did a little bit more doctoring. The resin surface just wasn't getting a smooth enough finish, so I took a piece of very thin paper-like styrene sheet. And you get these in all different thicknesses, all different sizes and such, but this one's really nice. I like it a lot. It's just like paper, but it's plastic, so I can cut it with scissors and get that nice smooth plastic finish, and it works well with any kind of glues as well. I just glued it in place, and I did the same on that side to get a smooth edge to it. Looks really nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and get a coat of flat white on this just to see what other parts I have to smooth out. There's a few spots like right there you can see that are rough. I need to smooth that down a bit before I get a final coat of paint on top. But those two worked out really well. Let me show you how the mechanism is going to work. I initially was going with all of the super strong magnets, and it turned out to be a little too powerful, as I showed in the last video. So the ones inside just would not let go. And no matter what I did, this would not release. So I replaced them. Let me show you what I did here. Wrong side. All right, so that's how that's gonna come off, nice and easy. So I left the super strong magnets on the inside there, as you can see, but I replaced the inner ones with some weaker rubber-based magnets. So they don't hold on quite as strongly, but they are strong. This isn't going anywhere, as you can see. That's not coming out no matter what I do. So it'll hold the compartment in place nicely, so I can cover that up. And if I need to remove them, I just use the battery, as I showed you here, to remove the magnets. So it's easy to replace it. All right, so quite a bit of work on these. And they turned out very nicely. I like the design that I finally ended up with, but I tried a bunch of different options, as I showed in my previous videos, everywhere from just cutting some out of styrene and putting them on, and I didn't like the curve in them, so I made some mold boxes and then cast some resin versions, which, as I showed, I had a little bad experience with some bad resin, and finally got that done, and after several casts I got a nice resin piece that has the nice curve that I want. And even then I had a little bit of trouble because of the gap that was there. So I like the final evolution, as it may be, that I came up with, where I designed a plate that looks like it belongs on the bottom of the sub with some rivets and a nice smooth part. So we'll go ahead and get that painted with a flat white, and then we're pretty much ready to go ahead and get the bottom painted with the final color, and I'll show you that here in just a few minutes. All right, so I did some sanding of the rough parts. I got a coat of flat white on it, and then I went ahead and put on an initial coat of the final white paint that I'm going to have on the Proteus on the outside of it.
I got the idea from another YouTube video from Lou Del Masso. He made an excellent Proteus that he did a lot of really nice scratch building and parts on it, which is awesome. And he is using a paint, which is an automotive paint from Duplicolor, and it is Polar Arctic White. And so it was a great idea. Thanks, Lou. I got a can of this, and I really like it. It has a nice satin finish. It's almost like a metallic finish when it's done. I'm putting on some very fine coats at first because I have to be very careful with the gloss paints. They tend to get ripples or pull effects, and once you ruin it, you're building the whole thing again, and it's kind of a pain. Lots of sanding, so I don't want to do that. But you can see how my battery compartments are blending in quite nicely. And I have one over there as well. There we go. And as I showed in my previous video, those will come off easily with a magnet, but they'll stay nice and secure without it. So it's hard to see, but you can see just a bit of a sheen right there from this white. It's going to right there as well. It's going to take several coats to get that semi-gloss sheen that I want from it, but it's a really nice paint. It goes on well, and obviously it's made for automobiles, so it does have kind of a metallic finish to it, which is kind of cool. So I really like it. It's going to give me the finish I want, and I probably won't even need to do any kind of sealing on it to seal it down. Once it dries, it'll have a nice sheen as well. So this is pretty much almost done. I have both of my battery compartments in place and ready to go. The hatch is ready to put on the bottom there once I'm done painting it. I have one of the intake grills. I still have one more grill to make on the right side, or the left, I guess, if you're looking at it from the front. The front section is completed. I just have to get that glued together and put into place. And then I'm almost done on the bottom of this kit. And then I can go ahead and start focusing on some other parts on the top. All right, well, let me go ahead and get some more work done on this, and we'll see what we can come up with. All right, so I'm correcting an error in the kit that I showed in a previous video. The inside molded part of this kit, these two curved sections, you can see that I have spliced in a little bit longer piece. The original kit came with a part that ended about an eighth of an inch above this little bottom section. I'm not sure why they didn't make that just one solid piece, but in any case, it was off considerably. So I took my second kit. It doesn't look very pretty, but I cut that middle section out. And then I took the two curved pieces. You can see how I spliced them in there. And right now they're drying. Once it's done, I will putty that inside edge and sand it smooth so it blends in. But now that that bottom section comes right down. You can see that bottom curved line. It'll match up with the bottom of this other one and on the other side. So correcting that issue. So once I put this piece on here, those two bottom edges will line up right with this one and this one right here. There won't be that big eighth of an inch gap between them. So I do have the back glued in now. A little bit more masking around the end of it, around the edge of it. I'm sorry. I'll have to put some black paint just to take that off. And a little bit of glue over lapping there. I'll get some, a little bit of a flat coat on there. So, all right, and that's about ready to glue in place. So the bottom is just about done. I'm going to slowly put on some light coats of the Polar Arctic Polar Arctic White from Duplicolor. And it goes on nice, but I have to get a couple of coats to get a nice even sheen across it. I have my battery compartments all ready to go. The hatch is ready to go on once this is all done. The front will be done, and I just have to do one more of these side grills, and that'll be completed. And we'll move on to the top of the sub and the rest of the interior. All right, and here is the pretty much completed bottom of the hull. I have nearly finished painting the bottom of it. A few more coats of some semi-gloss to get the shine that I want on it. But other than that, I have the bottom hatchway ready to go. My battery compartments are in place. I have the two intake grills on either side completed and painted. In the front grill as well, modified. The only thing I have left to do is to paint these little ribs right here, a medium gray. Once I get a final coating on the bottom and it's ready to go, I will get that done as well. But that turned out really well. Get a little better shot of that. So I'm going to go ahead and put this aside. I do a little bit more of the coating on it for the seal, for a semi-gloss. Kind of give you an idea that's what it's going to look like when it's done. Get a nice bit of a sheen on it. But other than that, that is all completed and ready to go. I will go ahead and finish working on the top and the interior. Alright, so I'm using some Panzer Gray to paint these masked off parts. I thought I had it pretty well covered, but I didn't. Got some overspray on the back of it and somehow got down inside. So no big deal, I'll get that sanded a bit and get a final coat of the white on it again. But go ahead and let that dry completely before I remove those and get those ribs a nice medium gray. So I thought I had enough masking to protect these ribs, but apparently not. So messed it up a bit. Also had some overspray, which just way too windy out. I should have been more cautious, but not a big deal. I'll get this cleaned up. I'll get these sanded down and then do the reverse. I'll mask off these ribs once they dry, get a flat coat on them, and then clean up those edges, make them look better. All right, well, let me get working on that. All right, and here is my finished bottom hull. As I said, lots of work, lots of redos, starts and stops, but it turned out nicely. The finish is a little rough, but it's going to be fine for the bottom. It's my first try, so it's a little hard to get that shine that I want, the semi-gloss. But there's the front of it with the grills. That little bit of detail inside there that I made. There's the two bottom grills, or I'm sorry, side grills, intake grills. There's my hatch, my opening hatch. There are my two removable battery compartments. And they can be pulled out with a magnet so I can change the batteries. So there we go. I think that turned out really well. So that one's ready to go. I'm gonna put that aside for now and continue working on the top of the hull and the interior. All right, so there we go. All right, so now that I've completed the bottom hull, I'm returning to the top hull section. And as I showed you in a previous video, I made my own snorkel and hose mechanism here, which is going to extend out of the top of the sub. So I showed a couple of videos early on about a spring-loaded mechanism. So I've decided to go with something a little more simple. It's not something I need to have spring tensioned to come out of it. So I'm going with a little more simple mechanism where it will just have a little weight on it. It'll pull it down into the sub and then have a magnet holding it in place. So in order to accommodate that, I had to cut out that top section. You can see it's very uneven.
So I need to finish that off a little better so it's more even, because it has to be larger. My snorkel part that I made is bigger than the actual opening that the kit comes with. So I cut that out. In addition, I have a piece of the wall section glued on, and I extended it out so I have some room in there in between, you can see from that, and the actual front wall for the mechanism to be seated in. So when you look at the back, you're going to see that back lab wall. It's extended a bit, so I have room for the mechanism. So in order to even out this part here, I once again went to my second kit and cut a part off of it. Once again, looking really ugly. So I just cut that top section off so I can get the nice finished edge. And here it is right here. All right, so I sanded it down a bit. I still have to enlarge the inner part, but it's a little easier with this piece so I can make it nice and even so that it'll fit. I don't need to shave off too much, but what I'll end up doing is take this piece once I get it all done, and that'll just go on here. Okay, so it'll look finished and nice, have that nice top lip on it, and cover that up when I'm done. So I'm gonna go ahead and even this out a little bit more on the inside and make it nice and thin so it doesn't take up too much more of the top here, but it matches up with the right inner shape that's right there, so it looks a little more finished on the top. All right. All right, and so here's the mechanism I came up with in order to have the snorkel inside of it. Like I said, I wanted to keep it really simple, so I just glued on some styrene sections to make a little chute. On the end there, you can see there is a magnet. It's just a rubber-based magnet. And at the bottom of this chute, it just curves just a little bit, if you can see there. So it can accommodate the little piece of the snorkel hose coming through, and I'll show you that in a second. So if you look at it from the top, you can see that's going to line up with it right down through that chute. And what's going to go inside of there is a little teeny box that I made up out of some squares of styrene, put a bottom on it, and inside of this I'm going to put some of the super strong magnets, these tiny ones here, two of these. I'm gonna put them inside with some 5-minute epoxy, not this whole piece, but just two of them, glue them down inside, and they will stick to that magnet inside. So let me show you how that's going to work here. All right, so there's the snorkel in place in the top of the sub. And then underneath it, you can see that it'll come through underneath. There's a little piece of plastic. I actually have it upside down, but in any case, this hose will be shortened to length. It'll be glued inside this little sliding mechanism. Turn it upside down. So that's actually the other way. And as I said, this will have magnets, so the magnets will stick to this when I stick it down inside. And it'll be able to be pulled away, so when I pull the snorkel away, this slider will just slide up and it'll stop at the end because it can't go further. And there'll be, this will be glued obviously and cut down to match up this end here. And there'll be a top piece of plastic over top of this so that this sliding mechanism will be inside. And it'll just move back and forth like that. I'll make sure that it fits nice and loosely in there so it can move. So when I pull out the snorkel, the magnet will detach from the bottom, this mechanism will slide up, and it will stop at the end. And when I put it back in, I'll just push it down. It'll come in and touch the magnet and hold in place. So in the end, we'll have this obviously cut to length and glued inside like that. So that's how it's going to look. And all this whole mechanism will be concealed. You won't be able to see it in the back wall. Take that out of there. There's my snorkel. Alright, well anyway. Alright, so from the back of the wall, when you see in the back lab windows, this will be covered up and you won't see that mechanism, you'll just see that back wall. In the front of the sub, you can't see it now, but the actual wall piece will be in front of this, and it will be concealing it from the front, so you won't see that at all from either side. So that'll work nicely for the purposes that I want to be able to remove the snorkel and pull it out of the sub. And the snorkel doesn't really have to be that long. Once I extend it, it'll stick out like this and it'll hold in place, and then I'll just stick it right back down inside like so, and it will line up with that magnet and hold it in place, so I can just grab it and pull it out like that. So very nice. So once I get that all done, this will be the last thing to go in once I get the whole top painted, of course, because I don't want to have to mask that off and get that clear or the red painted at all. So that'll be the last thing that I will attach, and then this whole mechanism will be in place and ready to go. So, okay, great.
All right, so this is going to pretty much wrap up part 10 of my Proteus build. A lot of progress. Finally got the bottom hull completed through all the trials and tribulations. Started working on the top hull as well. Got the mechanism all worked out for my snorkel to come out of that, so I'm happy with that and the way that's all going. So I wanted to end this video and talk about a secondary companion project that I'm going to do along with my Proteus. And what that's going to be is another Proteus. All right, so before you think that I'm crazy or insane, I'm not doing a full build of this second one. What I want to mainly do is create just the exterior of it. And two reasons I want to do that. One, I want to get it all test fitted and test painted and just make sure everything's going to look right for my final build. But mainly what I want to do is I want to build one that I can weather. As I talked about early on, the Proteus itself in the movie, by the time it gets to the end, that ship is way beat and dirty and filthy and just grimed up from being inside the human body. And then it gets destroyed. Sadly, it goes down at the end by the antibodies and the little, looks like cottony, pieces of cotton coated in Vaseline. I always think that's what they look like, but they come down and devour it. And you see it dissolving the top bubble with poor Dr. Michaels, our villain, is done in by the antibodies of the Dr. Bennis that he's trying to kill. So a little bit of irony and justice there. But I want to do a diorama, probably within the human brain, with the antibodies and the ship, you know, pretty much all grunged up and virtually destroyed. I'm also thinking about making two versions of the bubble on the top, one with it just melted away with the white cottony antibodies on top of it. So I think that'll be pretty cool. And a little Dr. Michaels figure inside there. So I'm not doing any scratch building on this. I'm not doing any extra parts other than before I build it all together, I'm going to paint the inside of the front scoop like I did on my other one. Just paint it black, no extra detail. I'm going to paint the silver little insides of the side intakes. Those are also not going to be scratch built in any way. And other than those, I'm just going to build the whole thing first, paint it entirely, and start weathering it completely. I've already started working on one of the pieces. This is the clear window glass, of course, and I used some Tamiya smoke to make it look tinted and to mask off that interior. So so you won't see in there, since there's not going to be any detail inside the kit or anything. So that won't take as long to put together. The build is going to be the easiest part, and I can do some test fitting and make sure that that's going to go together right. So when I do my main one, it's going to be working good. So I'm going to start working on that as a companion. It's not going to take away from my build of the main one. I'm still focusing on that. So, but I really want to kind of put my hand into some weathering. I haven't done that before, and I've seen some great videos online about it. Lou Dalmasso does a great job on a lot of his models that he weathers with a lot of the techniques that he uses with acrylics. Another great YouTuber I watch a lot is Bashing Kits. He does a lot of Star Wars and does a fantastic job. Check out his Svedka Star Destroyer. It's amazing the detail he put on that. But I really like their techniques, so I'm gonna kind of mirror some of them. Nothing you know, really extenuous, but just kind of give it that really dirty, grunged up look to the Proteus. So let me finish up this video with a few pictures from the movie showing you how that looks in the end and kind of the idea that I'm going for. All right, and I will see you in part 11.
End of the laser. You said there was a quick way out.
We could follow the optic nerve to the corner of the eye.